let's talk about the $600 RTX 4070 and the $800 RTX 4070 Ti. Now, both these GPUs are equipped with 12GB of GDDR6X video RAM on a 192-bit memory bus, and this provides an impressive 504GB per second of memory bandwidth. However, the RTX 4070 Ti for an additional $200 offers approximately 30% more CUDA cores and two media encoders as opposed to just one in the RTX 4070. But does this justify the extra $200 cost for the RTX 4070 Ti? Now, at the time of its release, the RTX 4070 Ti faced huge criticism due to its steep price tag. This is because the RTX 4070 Ti provided around half the performance of RTX 4090 for around half the price, and that's really not a generational improvement. For example, the previous generation RTX 3070 Ti delivered 65% performance of RTX 3090, the flagship card from that era, at 40% the price. And that's what we expect, right? We want more performance for the same price. Don't give me more performance for more price, like that's not progress. So let's take a look at the DaVinci Resolve benchmarks. So we find that the RTX 4070 Ti showcases an 11% improvement in GPU effects compared to RTX 4070. This is largely due to RTX 4070 Ti's additional CUDA cores. However, in the extended overall score, the RTX 4070 Ti is practically on par with the RTX 4070. The story is similar in the Adobe Premiere Pro extended overall benchmark, as both the RTX 4070 Ti and RTX 4070 demonstrate very similar performance levels. So in my opinion, investing an additional $200 in the RTX 4070 Ti is not justified. The only caveat here is that if you intend to engage in 3D animation using something like Blender, then RTX 4070 Ti makes sense. And this is because the extra CUDA cores that are present in RTX 4070 Ti, they help it deliver a remarkable 24% performance boost in the Blender benchmark compared to the RTX 4070.